And then this next one is called Eternally Bleeding, so this one's like a little bit longer. Eternally Bleeding. Just read a tragic story about a little girl with cancer, brutally made fun of, no cure and no answers. See, a little girl started to lose all of her hair, and not a single person in her life even cared. It seemed as if God wasn't there. But Jesus told me the saying before, without suffering there'd be no compassion. I was too young to understand what he told me before, but after reading this story, this quote came forth. But God, how do you choose the ones to suffer, the ones who go to war, or the girl neglected by her dad who grows up to be a whore? How could you possibly choose the ones who must lose their loved ones, like my dad with his son, or my friend's dad when his head met out his gun? I ask you every day, God, why me, why me? And he replies, Katie, I know you're the one who needs the strength. And don't forget your brother Michael still watches every move that you do, every thought that you think, every night when your dad picks up that drink. You have two angels, but one of them is still on earth with you. So why did I choose you? Because I could see you were internally bleeding, believing you couldn't succeed, couldn't achieve the thoughts in your dreams. We saved you from dying in that seizure, and you are just as good, if not better, than the ones who precede you. The little girl with cancer died. The mother was cold as stone. She couldn't even cry. The father was so heartbroken, all he could do was sigh until he picked up a needle and started to get high. Those parents are internally bleeding right now, bleeding viciously like the ink from your pen when you write. So don't you ever give up the fight. No one ever said I was choosing the lives that are worth losing. I do what is right, he told me, and that's life.